And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday. It's the 11th of May, 2021. It was on this day in 1812 the waltz was introduced at a dance hall in London, the first closed couple dance the English aristocracy had ever seen, men and women embracing one another as they were dancing. It was on this day, the year 868 A.D., the Diamond Sutra was printed, the world's oldest book bearing a specific date of publications, a collection of Buddhist teachings, a dialogue between the Buddha and Subhuti, one of his elderly disciples. The copy was printed with wood blocks on 7 strips of paper, each page from a single block, 7 sheets bound together to form a scroll about 16 feet long. The Diamond Sutra was discovered near Dunhuang in the Gansu province of China, a desert outpost along the Silk Road. Buddhist monks kept their scriptures in caves where the dry desert air kept these paper texts in perfect condition. The caves were sealed off around the year 1000, perhaps because the Islamic Empire was spreading into Western China. And it was 900 years later, in the year 1900, when an itinerant Taoist monk named Wang Yuanlu happened on them, realized that he'd found something special. And then the archaeologist Aurel Stein showed up in Dunhuang. He was Hungarian, but he was working for the British, and he convinced Wang Yuanlu to part with a huge amount of manuscripts for a little bit of money. And Aurel Stein left the caves of 1,000 Buddhas with 24 cases of manuscripts and 5 cases of paintings and relics, for which he paid £130. Today is the birthday of Mari Sandoz, born near Hay Springs, Nebraska, 1896. Her father, Swiss homesteader, harsh, bitter man. Her mother, cold and remote. Mari Sandoz, the oldest child of 6. She published her first story when she was 11 years old, and when her father found out, he beat her and he locked her in the cellar. He didn't approve of writers. She went to school sporadically whenever her parents would let her go. She was 17 before she finished the 8th grade, and she snuck off to take the school teacher's exam. She started teaching even without going to high school, and as soon as she was 18, she got married just to escape from her family. Her husband was as harsh as her father was. She divorced him 5 years later, citing extreme mental cruelty. She wanted to be a writer, and when she was 32, she was summoned home to see her father on his deathbed, and his dying wish was that she would write his life story. She'd always wanted to write about the West, and so she did the research and wrote the biography called Old Jewels. It came out in 1935. It became a Book of the Month Club selection. And finally, thanks to her father's biography, she was able to support herself as a writer. Famous for the book Old Jewels and also for Crazy Horse, the strange man of the Oglalas. Here's a little poem for today by William Wordsworth. Glad sight wherever new with old. Glad sight wherever new with old is joined through some dear home-born tie. The life of all that we behold depends upon that mystery. Vain is the glory of the sky, the beauty vain of field and grove, unless, while with admiring eye we gaze, we also learn to love. Wrote William Wordsworth. That's the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, May the 11th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.